Auto 060 y tal como les prometimos, ahora vamos a hablar del nuevo Kia K900 2015, el auto de más lujo jamás fabricado por el fabricante coreano, con el cual está siguiendo los pasos, digamos, a la inversa de Mercedes-Benz, que presentó el CLA por debajo de $30,000, de Maserati Ghibli, que curiosamente tiene el mismo precio que este Kia K900 y es un auto muy interesante. Así que para eso vamos a hablar con Michael Sprague, que es el vicepresidente de ventas y de mercadeo de Kia para Estados Unidos, que nos invitó para estar en California, en Newport Beach, para la presentación del Kia K900 2015.
Well, Michael, thank you very much first for having us here in a beautiful Newport Beach at the Pelican Hill Resort, one of the most exclusive and beautiful resorts in the U.S. for the presentation of the equally beautiful Kia K900. You're entering a different territory for Kia, and this is something that some people are, you have people talking about this.
Sure, in a good way.
Yeah.
Because people are so surprised by what we're doing. I mean, we've been in the U.S. for the last 20 years, and we continue to challenge traditional automotive thinking, both from a product standpoint and from a marketing communication standpoint. And this is the latest example, an all-new luxury sedan from Kia.
Yeah. Some of a former executive at Mercedes-Benz actually used to say that it was easier to get down from the penthouse to the lobby than going from the lobby to the penthouse. But I think that has changed because technology, good thinking, I mean, like, good talent in design and engineering, that has like changed the whole game for everybody. And this car is an example of that, right?
Yes, absolutely. What we're asking people to do is challenge that traditional convention of what a luxury car is. So many people think it's all about tradition and heritage. And to your point, what we're saying is, no, it's different. It's about design. It's about technology. It's about quality. It's about these new and up-and-coming brands that people want to be associated with.
Yeah. And some people also, I mean, people who have a lot of money maybe don't want to show it off that much, right? And I think this is maybe one of those examples in, like, they said, okay, I see this car. I know about money. I see this is, the most you can spend on this is $66,400, right?
$66,000, yes, exactly.
And so people say, I mean, I get a lot for that money. So maybe that's another way of, as you were saying, people seeing luxury in a different way.
Yeah, absolutely. And you hit it spot on. There are people who are looking for alternatives to what everybody else has. Everybody has this sense of discovery. Everybody wants to be the first to say, I found it, or I've got one first. And that's exactly who we're appealing to. With the K900. It's people who recognize everything that they're getting because this is fully competitive with every other luxury manufacturer, but at a great value. And that's what's exciting to people.
Yeah. And in terms of not the initial value, but the residual value, let's say 3-5 years, what's the message for the people? Because there's also talk about that.
Yeah, sure, absolutely. In fact, Automotive Lease Guide has given us the forecasted residual for this car, and they're telling us it is the highest in the segment. So that's very exciting. They said this is truly a luxury car. And so, you know, we've got now third-party endorsers saying, yes, this is a luxury car. You should have no issues with buying this car.
But it's still, I mean, people are harder to convince sometimes, right? So what's going to be the strategy for convincing those people first to take a look, maybe take a test drive, and like ultimately buy this car?
Yeah, you're right. It's so from a marketing standpoint, the message that we're communicating to consumers is challenge the luxury you know. Take a different approach. Take a different look at it. And that's why we launched the vehicle in the Super Bowl. What better platform? 111 yeah. million people watching, and we're saying, hey, challenge what you traditionally think of as a luxury car, because this is the new luxury. So we'll continue to do that. We used a spoof off of the Matrix movie, where Lawrence Fishburne, acting as Morpheus, challenges Keanu Reeves to, you know, take the blue pill and go back to the luxury you know, or take the red pill and see a whole new world. And we did the same thing, but using a blue key versus traditional luxury and a red key, which is the new luxury. So that will continue to play. We'll also get into experiential marketing, making sure that people get into the product and experience it.
Yeah, and for what I understand, that commercial was pretty successful, right?
Yeah, it was. We saw immediate shopping data in third-party sites like Edmunds and Auto Trader. We also, in our own internal data, saw Kia.com search spike dramatically, and we also saw opinion for the brand rise dramatically.
Well, thank you very much again, and I guess congratulations. You just got a new title, or an addition to your title, right? So you're going to be much busier now.
Yes, exactly, but still promoting these great products.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Michael, and I'll see you soon, maybe in New York in the Auto Show.
Great. Thanks,
Thank
Javier.
You. Bye.